So now let's understand certain important concepts or certain important things about the square numbers or square and square roots, so that it becomes easier for us to understand those and say about the numbers. Now, first thing is that whenever you are asked that whether a particular number is a square number or not, you need not do the prime factorization every time. Certain things can be known just visually by seeing the units place of that particular number. Because if the units place does not have a particular number, then it is definitely not going to be a square number. Let's see what exactly I mean to say. 1 ka square is 1. The square of 2 is 4. Square of 3 is 9. Square of 4 is 16. Square of 5 is 25. Square of 6 is 36. Square of 7 is 49. Square of 8 is 64. Square of 9 is 81. And square of 10 is 100. So in case, if you observe over here, you find that the only possible units place, the only possible units place out of 0 to 9, which can be a square number, are 1. You can see 2 nahi hai, 3 nahi hai, so 2 is not there, 3 is not there, 4 is there, 5 is there, 6 is there, 7 is not there, 8 nahi hai, 9 is there, and 0 is there. So this possible to be squares, not possible. So now, if somebody just even tells you randomly what will it that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 2 is a square number or not, just looking at this 2 over here, you can say no, it is not a square number. Similarly, if somebody tells you that if is number 5, 7, 0, 3, 2, 5, 0 to 5 is a square number or not? Yes, it is possible. So here I may do the prime factorization and try to find out that what whether it is square number or not. But if this one is over here 7, then I'm sure that it is not a square number. So I don't need to do any kind of prime factorization and just tell that no, this is not a square number. Understood? So if the numbers, if the units place of any number contains 2, 3, 7 or 8, if the units place contains any digits that is out of 2, 3, 7 and 8, then definitely that number is not a square number. Okay? Next thing is, whenever any number is such that it has got only one zero at the end, that means if the number is 540 or it is 70 or it is 9740 or maybe if it is 54000 or 712345, that means if the number of 0 in is odd, then not a square. A square number will be the one which will have the numbers of zeros as even number. Like it could be 400, 900, or 100 itself, or maybe 1 and 4 zeros, So you can see, if the number of zeros in the number is 1, 3, 5, 7, then it cannot be a square number. But if the number of zeros in the number be in 2, 4, 6, 8 form, that is even numbers, then it could be a square number. Then you may go for the prime factorization of that particular thing and finding out whether it is actually a square number or not. Like 500, 500 mein do zero hai, but it is not a square number. So it is not necessary that all the numbers which will be having two zeros over here or four zeros will be a square number. But the possibility of it being a square number is there. But here, if it is 1 0 or 3 zeros or 5 zeros, 100% they are not square numbers. So just by viewing the particular number, the decimal point, the units place, or the number of zeros what is having in the units in the tens place, you can make out whether it is going to be a square number or not a square number. Another important trick what we can have is the numbers which are ending with 5. If any number is ending with 5 and I want to find out the square of that particular number, I can use a trick over here. Like suppose we have got the number 25 and I want to find out the square of 25. What I'll do is, I know that 5 ka square is 25. Then I'll find out what is the next number to 2 in the number system. 2 ke baad aata hai 3. So I'll multiply this by 3. So 3 2s are 6. So the answer is 625. So 25 ka square is 625. I'll show you one more example so that you understand proper. Let's take 45. 5 ka square 25. 5, 4 ke baad kya aata hai? 5 aata hai. So 4 into 5 is 20. So 45 square is 2025. And that can be applicable to any number. Like it is 105. 5 ka 25. 10 ke baad kya aata hai? 11. So it is 110. So the answer is 11025. This could be very handy, because every time doing the multiplication of 105 into 105 would have been very tough. Or time consuming, not tough. Time consuming. This is an easier method to find out the squares of numbers ending with 5. Okay, so that was the some important things about the squares and square numbers. There are many things given in the textbook, but normally they are not so much useful. So we'll skip that thing. And in fact, as per my what I have been seeing in the previous years in the 8th standard, I can see that in exercise 3.2, normally they used to do the question number 1, 2, 3 and 4, and then they used to skip the 5, 6, 7, 8 and other the other sums. So we will be doing only question number 1, 2, 3, 4 over here right now. In case your school sends you any worksheet or any kind of a session, or they're telling you that you are doing exercise 3.2 and you are doing sum number 5 or 6 or 8 or something, do let me know so that I can incorporate that in the video in the next time. So right now what we'll do is we'll just go for the exercise 3.2, sum number 1. So that's exercise 3.2, sum number 1. Write 5 numbers which you can decide by looking at their ones digit that they are not square numbers. So you, as I told you, what are the numbers which will be not a square number? So we had got that thing as it was ending with 2 and then it was 3, then it was 7, 7 and 8. Yeah, so this was the 4 numbers which will be there. So 2, 3, 7 and 8. So we can just make any number having the end over here. So this is quite a not an important thing at all. So first one, we are just 5 numbers will be 1002, or we can make it as 1315 43, and then we can make 47127 and then 56178 and 12311. Oh sorry, but 1, 2, yeah, that's fair. We can make use anything over there. So this is quite a silly question to ask. Anyway, the next one, What will be the units digit of the square of the following number? So now they are not asking us whether you need not square it. You just want to know that what will be the units place of the numbers of this particular square number. So when I'm taking the squares of these numbers, what will be the units place be? So the first question over here is 951. Now since it's ending with 1, so it will be 1. So as I had written over there, the first thing is that 1 ka ending will be 1, 2 ka ending will be 4, 3 ka ending will be 9, 4 ka ending will be 6, 5 ka ending will be 5, 6 ka end will be 6, 7 ka end will be 9, 8 ka end will be 4, 9 ka end will be 1, and 0 ka end will be 0. This is what is the ending of all the numbers which are ending with this, and the square of this is going to be there. So 1 ka 1, we can say the third one. So third one will be when it's 329. So 329, you know it's 9, 9 is will be 1, so it will be 1 again. Then the fifth one, question number 5 is 5124, so it's 4, 4 will end with 6, so it will be 6 over here. Then the seventh one, seventh is 68327, it's ending with 7, so it's 9, so it will end with 9. And then the ninth one is 99880, because ending with 0, so it will end with 0 over here. Okay, so this is quite simple. You are just going to find out that from this particular kind of a table. Now this table is very easy. You are just writing the squares over here. 1 ka square is 1, 2 ka square is 4, 3 ka square is 9, 4 ka square is 16. So we are just interested in the units place, so that's why I've written only 6. 5 ka square is 25, so I have written only 5 because we are interested only in units place. 6 ka 36, so only units place. 7 ka 49, only units place 9. 8 ka 64, only units place 4. 9 ka 81, only units place 1. And 10 ka 100, which is only units place 0. We come to the next question. The following numbers are obviously not perfect squares. Give reason. So it is over here, the third ka first. They are given that 567. So because 567, you know, 7, it is never any number can be ending with 7. So it is not square, perfect square. Square as units place is 7. Okay. Similarly, the third one is 5298. Again, you cannot see any 8, so not unit, not perfect square as units place is 8. And last one, fifth one, is 74000. Now here you can see the number of zeros over here is odd, so not perfect as number of zeros is odd over here. That is, that's why it is not a perfect square. So that was about the question number 3. We jump to question number 4. The square of which of the following numbers would be odd number or an even number, and why? Okay, this is one more rule over here that, okay, let's understand it with this example. 1 ka square is 1, odd number, odd number. 2 ka square is 4, this is an even number, this is an even number. Odd number, odd number. Even number, even number. Odd, odd. Even, even. Odd, odd. Even, even. Odd, odd. Even, even. So what do we conclude? We conclude that the square of the odd numbers are odd, and the squares of the even numbers are even. Simple? So obviously, if you see the question number 4, the squares of which of the following numbers would be odd or even? It's a simple thing. The first one, so the fourth one, the first is 573. So because this is an odd number, so square will be odd. Third question, it is 8267. Again, it's an odd number, so square will be odd. Understood? Very simple. So this was what was there up till now. In the previous years also, they had done only up to this point. Because the further point what is there, it is not so important. They have never gone through these particular properties also earlier. So they never took this part. And hence, it is not to be done. In case they do it, do let me know so that we can go through that particular thing also. Okay, now the next thing will be, okay, just a minute. Okay, the next part is to do the prime factorization and finding out the squares using the prime factorization method. I think I'll better do this way. I'll just leave it over here so that we can just go through the sums which are already solved. That's it.